Welcome back to this session. In this particular session, we'll be starting off about use of wikis for group projects. So what I'll do over here is, first I'll talk about a little bit about the best practices that are there that many of you are also aware while you are doing group projects within your own courses or as part of within your own college. And I will just explore how wikis can be a useful tool for managing group projects. Towards the end of this particular session, I'll be showing you a group project activity that we have conducted as part of a course inside IIT Bombay, and we'll also show you some of the earlier wikis that we have created, where many participants collaborated for creating resources as a project activity. So, in this session, I'll be dealing with wikis as a technology for managing large-scale group projects. So, as you know, some of the best practices while designing group projects is to ensure that there is interdependence within the group members and also ensuring individual accountability. While providing this group project, there should be specific time devoted to discuss teamwork skills. Now, take the example of the OER course project that you are doing towards the in the coming weeks. So, by first ensuring that there is a team, you form a team and both of you discuss together as to what activity has to be done, and also ensuring that there are process documentations within OER, we are actually looking at these three guidelines, and there are specific times. So, this is the time that we are asking you to devote while discussing. So, the surveys that we take, the RC, the time that you spend within your RC right now are all towards, we are orienting you towards discussing about teamwork skills that are required. There are multiple activities where we are asking you to collaborate, and we are trying to reiterate the significance of the need for teamwork. Now, let me explain each of these points in detail. So, in creating interdependence, ensure projects are sufficiently complex, not merely complicated, needs breaking down, identify and solve steps, put it back together. So, the complex process within the OER, so OER creation might be challenging in itself, but additionally, there is also OER documentation where you have to spend a lot of time creating a document that explains what the OER is for. So, there are two parallel activities which are complicated in itself, but provided if you break it down further, so that is why each the OER documentation has 5 chapters. The first one being the basic introduction, the second about the design, third about evaluation, the actual OER, the fourth about evaluation, fifth about developing the community. These are all different pieces that each of you can take up and work on it. Similarly, creating goals that can only be met through collaboration. So, for an individual person, it may be possible to create one OER. So, for example, the flipped classroom activity constructors or any of the resource creation assignment that you are doing is actually generating an open educational resource. But what is different from all those resource creation activities and the final OER project? The final OER project also requires you to document the entire process of creating the OER. Why did you select a particular technology? Why are you selecting a particular topic? Why are you selecting a particular strategy? All these design decisions have to come in. Suppose this is a small class, how do you plan to do this in the small class? How are you going to evaluate this particular implementation? All these details have to be put in, and each of these chapters are the minor goals that you have to look at. And this is only possible through collaboration, and that is why we are saying that a team should be formed for creating the OER, and there should be collaboration between the team members. They should document whatever is they are discussing even if it is for a short time, and then develop the OER. Encourage team identity. So for example, via competition. So the team identity formation is happening through the final grading. So we haven't explicitly put in separate competition, like the top OER that is going to come, that for that and all, we have not actually put in this particular FDP, because there is an explicit competition in terms of peer review. A peer review mechanism is already in place that will ensure that each of the participant puts in sufficient time and tries to improve their OER so that they can get the maximum out of it. Now, assign roles and rotate. This we have left to yourself as to what roles, who will be the facilitator, who. So the only thing that we have asked you is to identify a team leader. So once the team leader is identified, the team leader can then say who will develop the first part of OER, who will do the documentation of chapter 1, who will do the documentation of chapter 2, etc. So, and the important thing is, there is a devil's advocate. What is a devil's advocate? Somebody who actually looks into your OER and tries to provide constructive feedback. Okay, this may not be the correct idea. This, how do you ensure that this evaluation is going to come? So within the team, there should be someone playing this role as to constructively criticize the work that that you are doing. And this is typically how interdependence is getting created. But you should also ensure that these interdependence does not result in fights or quarrels. So let me go to the second aspect of it, ensuring individual accountability. The goal is to ensure that you have to avoid sleeping partners or free riders. This is typical even in the student projects. There will be one or two students who won't actually participate in the entire group activity, but they are just present for the final presentation. And actually the work would have been done by a smaller subsection within the large group, the group. So, recommendation is build in some component of individual assessment in addition to group assessment. So, just like how your group OER is being assessed, there is an individual log that is being verified by IIT Bombay team. So, you will have to provide us with your individual logs, and this is being considered for the OER activity. So, this will be considered as a small portion within your OER activity. So, some other methods: midway individual reports, assigning roles, individual quizzes, and viva to any individual. So, this you can do within your own institution. So, suppose you are managing a group, a student group who is doing a final year BTech project or a final year undergraduate project. You can use these kind of mechanisms to actually ensure that each and every individual within the group is working and they understand their roles within the group. Now, the third and most important aspect, discussing teamwork skills. So, workplaces function by teamwork, which many students are unaware. So, over here, what would work out is having recent graduates come over and tell the importance of teamwork. So, this now you have screencasts, you know about web conferencing and other mechanisms. So, maybe while your students are doing a BTech project, you could arrange for AVIEW interactions with your alumni, or screencasts created by your alumni. You can ask your alumni to give screencasts so that the students get motivated. In our current FDP, we have actually provided this the teamwork importance through the mentors. So, the mentors were all part of a team in the previous FDP. So, for the course, they are like the alumni, the top performing alumni who are coming over in the second FDP and interacting with the participants. So, they are not just giving guest talks, they are giving you suggestions. So, each of your mentors' web pages, you can see the open educational resources that they have already created. So you can take cues and create your plan and create your own open educational resource and documentation by interacting with them. Now, there is also an issue of negative experiences. So, at this point, it is important that we address this. So, while the students are going about doing this, it is important that we ask you address these kind of preconceptions about group work and ensure that there is a positive positive vibe or a positive rapport within the group. So that is why we have asked you to form your own choice of group. So a team can be formed, you have to discuss between yourselves, and wherever you feel that you can provide constructively, that we are encouraging such a team formation in this particular FDP. Now, there are some individual participants who are unable to find a team. So over here, what we are going to do is, we are going to allot them to a particular group. Let's say there are like two or three participants who are from different RCs, but are from the same domain. We are going to tell them that, yes, both of you would be at different places, but we are going to give them specific instructions on how to interact well within distances and try to create an OER for themselves. So, there is also an issue where students do not know how to resolve conflicts or how to delegate tasks. So, it is important at this point to help them figure out, either individually or as a team or as the entire class, on how to move beyond conflicts and work on delegation. So, that is where these kind of interactive sessions that we are conducting gives assumes greater significance. So, we are having dedicated sessions where we clarify the OERs, and there are the within the sessions we provide you more information about how you can manage your OER, how you can do the various works within the stipulated period of time. Students may not know your expectations, and this may create a lot of problems. So, setting expectations not only related to project deliverable, but also to groups. Now, here, if you actually look at the OER documentation, the OER guidelines, we have clearly stated the learning objectives for the OER activity, both for the group as well as for the individual. And the structure of the entire OER project is such that each of the activity within OER actually aligns with one of the learning objectives that are there in the OER, the original learning objectives. Now, help them estimate time, potential pitfalls. Now, we will take this session to actually in the this session and the upcoming session to provide you with better estimates, better OER guidelines by answering your queries. Also, you have your mentors who will be able to give you much finer guidelines on what all could be a good OER and how much time you have for doing such an activity. So, if you are going to develop a full course as an OER, we would advise you not to do it, because it is sufficiently large and it requires a lot of effort. The OER documentation in addition will take up more time. Rather, we would advise you to focus on small aspects. Let's say I will create one LED and one LBD. That in itself is a good OER, provided you develop it well as provide a clear documentation for the OER. Now, having said all these, how will you consolidate all these processes in a single platform? Over the course of this FDP, you have been introduced to several technologies like web pages, AVIEW interactions, Padlet, learning management systems, and Drupal. But we are introducing a new technology right now. It's called Wiki. And specifically, I'll be talking about a Wiki software called Wiki Spaces. It's an aggregator which can be utilized for these kind of activities while doing OER. So what is a Wiki? The simplest definition is that Wiki is a web page that anybody can edit. Now, what is the difference between a web page and a Wiki? So you have already developed WordPress web pages. So there is one author for that particular web page. And audience are able to view that particular web page and provide comments on it. They are not able to create that particular web page while you are doing from the standard WordPress.com site. But unlike that, Wiki, the audience can also edit the Wiki. So this is the actual purest form of Wiki where everyone is allowed to view as well as edit. A classic example of a Wiki is Wikipedia that everyone is aware of. So as when once you log into Wikipedia, once you register in Wikipedia, you are allowed to edit and somebody else can then go on top of it and start editing your interface. So all the entire Wikipedia collection is a result of collaboration by several individuals. Group projects with Wiki. Wikis provide students with need to connect and use various pieces of existing knowledge, refine understanding through discussion and application. There is also possibility of peer review, both giving and receiving feedback, and most importantly, stronger written communication skills. But what you have to be aware of is, since there is a public edit, Wiki activities can be messy and chaotic without proper design and supervision. So exactly like a group project. It is complex but not very complicated. Provided you have the accurate instructions, this will not become too much of a complication. So with Wikis, one more advantage is that you can retrieve older logs and hence you can resume from any point. So for example, over 1 week you have added lot more information in Wikis and suddenly you want to go back to the day one where you had thought of some idea about the project. So Wikis provide this particular functionality of going back in and retrieving that specific dates, corrections that you have made or the page that you have created. What I'll do now is I will show you a group project that we had done using Wiki. So here we have used the Wiki of Wiki Spaces. So if you look into the screen, you will see the Wiki Spaces web page. You can access it by logging into wikispaces.com. So what you see now is a Wiki. So I've logged into my Wiki right now. Instead of the, this is my dashboard in Wiki Spaces, and there are these multiple projects that are available. So some of the other Wikis are public Wikis of which I am a member. What I'll do first now is I'll just look for the ET repository that we have created as part of a previous workshop. So the Wiki looks like this. You can see on the right hand side, Wiki home, projects, recent changes, pages and files and members. So in the home page, so if you actually type this, this Wiki is actually public. So you can actually come to this directly by typing on this particular web page, etrepository.wikispaces.com. You can see a description of this particular Wiki. So who can benefit from this Wiki, instructions to use this Wiki, group pages within this Wiki, and these two are two repositories that we created as part of two workshops. So I'll just go to the T10KT repository because this was done as part of a IST workshop. So this repository has files created by several remote centers. So you can see which all remote centers participated in this Wiki activity and the number of participants from each of these remote centers. Let me just go to one of the RC. So let me just select this has been edited by somebody from IPS Academy Indore. If you actually look at the history, so on the right hand side you see a clock like button, it will show you who all have edited this particular wiki. So let me just select. So this was initially done by the RSET IITB user, that which was me, and I will compare it with something that was done at a later date. So you can see that whatever is in red has been deleted and whatever is in green has been added in the latest version of the wiki. So all those initial dialogues were deleted and some new content was added in this particular wiki. So this is something that you have to be aware of, that when you develop public wikis, these kind of changes are possible. So you have to provide specific instructions, permissions about setting up of these public pages. Now what I'll do is I'll just show you the projects that we had. So this T10KT repository is a private. So this idea called permissions actually set up whether a particular project can be private. That means only very few individuals within that project can access that particular wiki page. And this T10KT repository, within this T10KT repository, we have this so many members who were able to edit. Now, if you were to look at the other repository, you can have lot of small projects. So for example, this is a page of a particular institute as who were part of the QEEE repository. Let me just select. So I think BMS College, you were part of the QEEE initial project and you have populated a page over here, and only the members from the BMS College were given access for this particular page, and you can see resources that were created as part of this particular workshop. So the instructions were clearly provided, indicate the domain. They were asked to create think, pair, share and peer instruction resources. So I'll just have a look at one of the first one, Master of Business Administration. So this is done by so two participants from the MBA group have created resources. So the first one is by Ms. Lakshmi Hegde. She has done a topic called TQM. So each of these have been hyperlinked, and you can see that PI and TPS activities, there were peer evaluation scores. So somebody, Pratima Bhatt from the same college, has actually evaluated this particular page. So we had done lot of peer review as part of this particular workshop, and the same has been incorporated in the wiki as well. So you can see all these resources are available to everyone. So once the workshop got over, we have now made it public to the wiki. So all these resources are available for free, and it is an open educational resource. All these resources are under Creative Commons. So this is available, and you can see lot of discussions that has been happening. So there is also possibility of commenting at the end of the wiki page, where there were lot of discussions that were happening by the participant, and this was me. But if more than one participants are there from the same college, they can also use the comment feature to interact with each other. So I'll just, what I'll do now is, I'll just, So this is about ET repository. Let me now show you one more wiki where we have used it in the course. So first I'd show you a workshop page where several institutions were part of a large scale workshop and they had created resources. There was also internal peer review within that particular workshop, and each of the peer had provided, so we had conducted peer review within the wiki. So this was about a large scale workshop, and within a course we had used this wiki for conducting an entire course project. So this course project was about creating a new technology solution as part of a academic course that we run in IIT Bombay. We have been giving this particular wiki for all the assignments and course projects for the past 3 years. So 2015, so this is a page that was created by students who took this course in 2015. I was a teaching assistant for this particular course, and we had used wiki extensively for documentation, discussion and other things in this particular project. So as you saw in the earlier, I'll just show you. The wiki spaces provides a functionality of projects. Within the course projects, you can see all the projects that were created across the timeline. I am selecting a specific team. So if you, so there were 8 teams and each of them had created their pages. So I'm just selecting one particular page. So the home page, it explained what all were the broad goals of the project, title of the project, learning goals, etc. And it also had links to the other pages within this particular wiki, which was used for the entire projects. So there was a peer assessment that was done. So this was the course project assignment. The rubrics were provided to everyone. So this is the page explaining how the assignment is going to be evaluated. The learning outcomes, timelines and associated assignments. You can see when each activity was due. So there were, first they had to give a project description. So I'll just zoom this in so that it is, I hope it is now clear to all of you. Assessing wiki based project activities, we had tried to incorporate each of those best practices. We had provided them the learning outcomes so that they will know what is expected from them. Then we had provided the timeline and associated assignments. So by 23rd September, they had to do the first project assignment. They had to do a reflection and feedback by 10th October. They have to provide a system specific functional specification document by 17th October. There was an interim presentation and it was done in wiki. So we used wiki as a presentation tool also. So this was done on 26th October. And finally, report submission. The entire report was actually a wiki page. And we had taken that particular page as the final group submission. The rubrics for evaluation were provided inside the wiki for each of the assignments. So for course project assignment one, what all we will be looking at, what is the targeted performance, what is not accepted, and with examples. Similarly, for assignment three, now for course project presentation, how will they be evaluated? And this was actually peer evaluation was done over here. So you can see there is a self-evaluation that is over here, and there is a separate page for peer evaluation. So I'll just go to that page. So they had uploaded their presentations and they had provided suitable links within the wiki. What all questions came from the instructor at the end of the presentation? What all questions came from the audience? What is the takeaway from the particular presentation? So that is the self-reflection. So there is a peer assessment and feedback which was provided by peers. So for example, so the instruction for peer assessment is provided over here. And the evaluation rubric you saw earlier. So each of them were providing their feedback and also looking at the rubrics and providing them a particular grade. So for example, demonstration of use case is written as exemplary. Mode of demonstration, it is given as exemplary. Use of IT principles is satisfactory, and they are asking us specific questions. So this was not explained by that particular group. So this is what this particular user has actually said over here. So there are people who provide detailed feedback, and there are also people who provide in peer assessment no feedback at all. So this is exactly like how it will happen in a regular teaching learning scenario. Some important things about these wiki, I'll just show you the settings. So in the settings, the basic information about who all are the organizers, members, when was it created, and you can see over here there is a provision of providing Creative Commons attribution, and I've given CC by SA version 3, which is actually used at that point of time. And the subscription mode is that is currently on our education plan, and it is free complements of wiki spaces. So this, if you are selecting wikis for education purposes, wiki spaces were providing free wikis for all the educators. Now, on the left hand side, you can actually see about the storage options. You can see how many page revisions, file revisions, the approximate space that has been used. Let me show a little bit about settings. ET repository, this wiki is meant to act as a, so all the description. Again, the application type, it is shown as, it is a classic wiki functionality. So classic wiki is where people can collaborate, there is archives, all these things is provided. But within wiki spaces, you can also decide it for a basic website, or it can be used as a classroom. So where teachers, students, they need real-time engagement, it can be used for classroom. It is advised only if all your students have access to a device, ICT device within your classroom. Only then select the classroom mode of wiki. Otherwise, use it in wiki mode because it allows for asynchronous collaboration. Again, each page having discussions, you can set whether it should be a one discussion for the whole wiki or one discussion tab per page. So it is allowing search engines to index my wiki, and it requires SSL transmission. I have also added Google Analytics, through which I can actually track the page visits and the other things related to this wiki. Permissions. Currently, the ET repository is a protected wiki, so only so everyone can view the pages, but only members of this wiki can edit the pages. If it is moved to public, then everyone, including anonymous visitors, can view and edit pages. And since this was a repository creation specific to the workshop, that is why it was kept as a protected one. If it were to be a private wiki, then only the members of the wiki will be able to access that particular wiki and edit the pages. So let me check what was the setting that I gave for the ET801 projects. So ET801 also, we have provided a protected setting, which means that you can view all the pages, but you will not be able to edit any page. So you can actually type et801.wikispaces.com and access this wiki. Similarly, ET repository, Another important thing, the license. Here you can see that there is Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license. So all the different options of Creative Commons is provided over here. There is also a possibility of copyright only, GNU free documentation license. So these are the different licenses that you can do, and there is also a custom license wherein you can actually create a license of your own and then apply that particular license for the wiki. Again, look and feel of the wiki, you can do different themes. There are style sheets as to how each font, how characters will look like. The content manager, where how you can access the wiki, the page types. Then you can have a overview of the statistics related to the wiki use. So over here, in October, there have been so many views and there are so many unique visitors. There is also different across different countries. You can view it across different timeline also. So I'll just look at 2014-15 December, where this wiki was more active. So then you can have the pages, different pages. So all the pages that are available in this particular wiki is listed over here. So there were 247 pages, and you can see some of these pages were deleted. And there is also a list of members across the time period where they were active. Those thing is also available over here. So let me look into the members. So while you are doing your group projects, if you want to track how many users were active in the wiki, there is a member statistics that is provided. So for example, each of them, how many edits, how many messages or discussions they participated in, all these information is available over here, and you can download them as a CSV or Excel file. So let me go back to the two wikis. So here is the lab activity for you for the coming 2 days. Explorewikispaces.com, create a wiki for your remote center where all the participants are members of the wiki. And what you have to do is populate it with various ideas of integrating MOOC content in your regular teaching learning scenario. So remember the session that we did just before the lunch, where we had elicited these ideas. So what you can do now is explore wiki spaces, create a wiki for your remote center, and then populate it with different ideas that each participant will have to look up various ideas through which they can integrate MOOCs within their own classroom, and identify few courses which they think would be good enough for integration. So you can explore different MOOCs. So we had provided a list of MOOCs to you before the in the last session. You can now go to Wiki Spaces. So how do you do this? Go to wikispaces.com. Click on sign in, If you have never used wiki spaces earlier, then you would be required to create a new wiki spaces account. So you can create a username, a password, and you should register it with your registered email address. And what you should do is you should make a wiki and where you say that you are part of the higher education group and then join it. So for example, let me show you how to do the creation of a wiki. So FDP, I am creating a username FDPICT. So now it shows me how I can create a new wiki. So let me give the wiki name fdpict.wikispaces.com. I provide the country, provide, so instead of school name, you can provide the institution name over here, provide the basic information. So I am P. And once you provide these basic informations, you will be able to create your own wiki. So at the remote center, you will have to, one of the coordinator should create a wiki like this. So now the educational wiki becomes a wiki classroom. Initially, there are no members in this particular wiki. What you can do is you can add the members by creating a join code. So what will happen is, once you click it, a join code will be activated and all the members, it will show you a code and you are given a particular website through which you can join this particular code. So everyone with this particular web URL, you just have to share this URL with the members within your RC to join this particular wiki. This is the easiest way in which you can register in this wiki. Or else, what you can do is you can use a bulk user creator where you invite people. So you can provide all the email addresses. So up to 100 email addresses, you can provide an invitation like this and send it. Or you can use a bulk user creator where you will create a CSV or Excel file of all the users and upload it. So these are the multiple ways in which this particular wiki can be populated. So I would recommend use of join code. So once you have done that, what you can do is go to the settings, make sure that your wiki is in Creative Commons. So in the permissions, always keep your wiki initially in private mode so that others can also view in protected mode. So allowing it for the protected mode, you will have to verify your account. So verification of your account is by phone. So if you provide your phone number, everyone, there will be a message, SMS that comes to your phone number. Once you provide that particular, it's like your OTP that comes for bank transactions. So you provide that particular number, then you will get additional options of creating public wikis, protected wikis, etc. Till that time, you can put your wiki in private mode such that only participants within your RC is able to access this particular wiki. Once you provide the basic permissions, then ensure that your wiki is in Creative Commons. So I would always recommend that you keep your wiki in Creative Commons share alike, such that so that anyone who is taking a resource from your wiki would also be required to keep those resources in Creative Commons. The basic things, once you have done it, then go back to your home. So explore the wikis as far as possible. Only thing is, ensure that there is a page that you create as an RC where you list down all the members and the various suggestions that each of these members provides on integration or use of ICT, integration of MOOCs in regular classrooms. So they should provide detailed description of how various ways in which they have tried it out or they are planning to try out. Others can then comment on, like I said, there should be a devil's advocate. So somebody within RC should look at the way in this is implemented and provide constructive feedback to the various individuals and ensure that at the end you have a composite list of, let's say, 5 to 10 different ways in which MOOCs can be integrated within your own teaching learning practice. So this is an open assignment. This will be open till 22nd of October. If you want detailed instructions, we'll upload the detailed instructions in a short while. Possibly by tomorrow evening, we'll provide a very detailed instruction as to what all is expected, what all you should be doing, what is the final result that we are expecting at the end of it. But for today and tomorrow, what we would recommend you to do is explore wiki spaces to the maximum so that you have a feel of various ways in which these various menu buttons and features are useful in the wiki. What I'll do right now is answering of queries. I understand that a lot of people will have a lot of queries because of the new technology that is there. You can now do a hand raise from 3:10 to 3:20. I'll be answering some of your queries regarding specifically the wikis first. From 4 o'clock, I'll handle all the queries regarding OER. So right now, if you have queries regarding wiki, please raise your hand. I'll be here to explain the entire the process that is expected from you. Let me go to RC1235.
I have an idea to create a MOOC in Google Classroom, sir, for the subject to for the students. I recently created a Google Classroom for the subject user interface design or network, computer network subject.
Okay.
I want to add materials, course materials and the teacher activity using the Moodle. That link will be added to the Google Classroom.
Okay.
I also added the users. One or two users I have added. So for example, I have given.
Okay.
Can be used for student community, sir.
Great. So, yes, that is one good way of using Google Classroom for online course. So blend of course. So you will have your half your interaction in your classroom and there will be activities within your Google Classroom, right?
Already I want to speak previous
questions. Yeah, I understood. So this is one way of integrating MOOCs in your regular teaching learning practice. So this is a good one. What I would recommend is, please make sure that while you are creating, the RC is creating the wiki spaces page, you mention this within the page itself, so that you can get feedback from others about your idea.
The wiki spaces also like a Google Classroom.
Yeah, exactly. So wikis are also like a Google Classroom. So unlike Google Classroom, this provides an additional option of creating, actually licensing the entire wiki in Creative Commons.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Are there any queries regarding wiki spaces within your RC?
Look, how many users can be added there, wiki spaces, sir? Wikispaces.com.
So there are no upper limits. So we have had the T10KT repository has around 5,000 users. So I hope that it will be sufficient for the FDP participants. So participants like 50, 60 is all will easily be managed in wiki spaces.
But for opening the wiki spaces, we are putting the wiki spaces will be created for the college. The students will be linked to this wiki spaces by only ID only.
Yes. So you will have to
send by the email ID.
Yeah. So everybody has to register to wiki spaces using their email IDs, and they will create a wiki. So just like how you create a what do you say, user account in any other application, you can get a user ID after by registering with your registered email ID. So IIT Bombay X, you have a username and you have a registered email ID, right? So similarly, wiki spaces will also have a user ID and a registered email ID.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. RC1290, yeah.
Okay, the question is that it's not very clear on what we should do using wiki on the wiki space. Can you please explain?
Yeah, so currently for today and tomorrow, we want you to explore wiki spaces to the maximum. So essentially what you did in the previous session, this will be what you will be doing across the coming week in wiki spaces in asynchronous format. So each of the participant from your RC will write one way in which they can think of integrating MOOC in their own regular teaching learning practice. So it's a written description that everyone will write. But before writing out the detailed description, it is important that each of you explore the functionalities in wiki spaces, for which you can take today and tomorrow's lab session to explore features, what all things you can do with wiki spaces, file uploads, page creation, hyperlinks, etc. So the detailed activity will be uploaded as a courseware activity where we'll give you specific instructions like what should be there. So like what all feedback. So you saw in the group projects, clear instructions were provided, right? Even with rubric. So similarly, clear instructions will be provided about the lab activity by tomorrow evening. But for the first 2 days, you are required to explore wiki spaces to the maximum so that each of the participants knows what all are possible within wiki spaces.
Okay, then how do I link then my wiki space with this FDP wiki space that we have also missed out? I mean, it's so fast.
No. So we have not provided specific instruction on linking with FDP's wiki spaces. This will be provided tomorrow evening. So the wiki page ID, and we'll be giving you a join code so that the RCC or the participant can join the main FDP wiki spaces. And there will be specific pages created for each and every RC. So you can go to your appropriate page and you can populate all that has been created over there. And then we will initiate a discussion across the coming 2 weeks where other participants will also come and visit your page and will provide their feedback. So it will be an asynchronous discussion that is happening across the coming, let's say till 22nd of October.
Thank you.
Yeah. So let me just reiterate what I just, so people who are having doubts or confusions about the wiki spaces activity, please note that today it is only meant for exposure towards wiki. So we have provided you with the idea of logging into a wiki, registering in a wiki, creating your own wiki page, and start collaborating within your own remote center. So in today and tomorrow, go on, explore the entire functionality of wiki spaces, like user creation, bulk upload of users, etc., etc. The clear instruction on what is required as part of the lab assignment will be providing you by tomorrow evening. So it will be there in the courseware by tomorrow evening, where we will provide you exactly how, what all things are required, how you can join the main FDP wiki spaces page, and specific pages will be created for each and every RC, where we'll be providing you a template using which you can fill all the information that is required, and then there will be asynchronous peer interaction. Remember, in the first face-to-face interaction, you had done using question answer using web pages. Now here, what you will be doing is discussion using wiki pages. So the focus theme of the discussion is integration of MOOCs in regular teaching learning practice. We want to elicit the different ideas that each of your RC members are having regarding integration of MOOCs, and if specific examples of practice are already available. So for example, in today morning, we had heard 2-3 instructors who are actually using MOOC resources in their regular teaching learning, and it is actually incentivized such that students also actively participate in those activities. So we want to find out how different instructors are using MOOCs, and for that we are using a platform called Wiki, which allows collaboration, which is based on the philosophy of collaboration. And we want more people to interact and get the ideas, share their ideas. Let me now go to RC 1313, KS Rangaswamy College.
Sir, in RCA 2, we have to use a YouTube video, right? For that, we have to put the Creative Commons license.
Yes, so it need not be just YouTube, it could be from any other resources, like it could be Vimeo or any other video aggregator.
Okay sir, if I have used a video from NPTEL, is it necessary to put the Creative Commons license in my RCA2?
If you have used an NPTEL video, just check whether the original NPTEL video is in Creative Commons. You will have to apply the same license while you are using the NPTEL video.
So if it is not in Creative Commons, what should I?
So you should get permission from the NPTEL channel or the instructor to use this particular video.
Okay sir, okay. And another one more question is regarding Wiki. There is an option in Moodles to create Wiki. Is it that same as what you said in Wiki spaces?
Okay, so Wikis, yeah, so the wiki that is going in Moodle, that is a different wiki because it is local to the Moodle. So, how would I put it? Students will be able to access that wiki only if they log into the Moodle. And it does not have functionalities like a wiki spaces, which is a dedicated wiki software. Moodle is a learning management system,
okay,
which has...
Sir, can we use that wiki for team pair share?
So you can use that wiki for think pair share within your classroom. That is so that is the technology that is available, and you are just utilizing a strategy. So you are just aligning the technology and strategy. So nothing wrong in doing that. That is exactly what is actually needed. So it's not just mere use of technology. You should actually do something constructive with it so that even students benefit.
Suppose if I am going to use a video from Project Askar, which has been created by IIT Bombay for RCA2, how can I use it? Because there is no, I couldn't able to download that video from Project Askar.
So Project Askar, so this question is regarding, though we are diverting from the main theme, but it is important that I address this at this moment. Project Askar is a content repository, animation repository that was created around 2010 as part of the IIT Bombay projects. If you want to use that particular video, they are all flash animations. So they are not exactly videos. They are animations created for some particular purpose. If you want to use that animations, you want to use it for out of class assignment or in class assignment?
Out of class assignment.
So what you can mention is that, so while using that, you should actually put that I am using the following resource. You should provide the hyperlink to where this resource can be downloaded, and you should provide what you are planning to do with it. That description should be there in out of class activity. But currently the flipped classroom activity rubric is created in such a way that it assumes that you are planning to use a video first and not an animation. So be careful while you are doing it. So what you can alternatively do is create a screencast where you are running this animation by yourself and upload that screencast as a YouTube video. Now from there you can actually give that YouTube link and say that you watch this video from so and so minute to so and so minute, and then it will be converted as a video resource.
Okay, once I use like that using screencast, I have to create a Creative Commons license for that, and then only I have to upload it.
Exactly. And I believe that Oscar is in Creative Commons, so you don't have to worry about the original license. So if you actually look at, so any of these IIT Bombay projects, they are in Creative Commons. But you should attribute it to Oscar. The original animation is from Oscar. You should give the appropriate attribution.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. So let me now go to the next remote center, Knowledge Institute of Technology.
Sir, my doubt is that is we were created WordPress. Now that is now we are discussing about why that is Wiki Spaces.
Yes.
So according to your point of view, which one is the best tool to project our content? this is my that is my personal question.
Okay.
And second one is, if we are using Wiki Faces, whether there is any limitation to upload the content, that is the size of the content.
Okay. Are there any other queries regarding wikis from your remote center?
Sir, is it possible to upload videos into the Wiki Spaces and use it?
Okay, so three questions. Let me take it from back. Is it possible to upload videos? Yes, it is possible to upload videos. However, we will always encourage you to embed videos rather than upload videos, because video size is pretty huge, and Wiki Spaces free plan, there is some size limitation. I don't exactly remember. I think the overall page size cannot be more than 5 GB. That's what I think was the initial settings that is there. So I would always advise you to embed videos. So, and this also answers the size limitation question that the first participant was asking me. There is some size limitation. I'll have to cross check once more. I think it is around 5 GB or 10 GB. I'll just check and confirm. If there are other Wiki Space users, I know a lot of people are using Wiki Spaces for their regular coursework. So, if others know of size limitations, do let me know. The last I used it in 2016. There were some file size limitations. Regarding your first question, which is better? See, it all depends on the learning purpose for which you use a technology. Now, any technology, if you actually see the LED videos that was released in the final week, for the purpose of constructive alignment, it doesn't matter what technology you use. As long as it is aligned to the learning objective, it is aligned to the instructional strategy, it is aligned to the assessment strategy, any technology is good enough. What we are showing you are various, so we are showing you various flavors of technology that is available within your immediately, and it is which is more generic. So these technologies can be used by an engineering teacher in engineering, or a teacher in science, or a teacher in who is doing management. So, or a teacher in law, architecture, all these are some, what you say, foundation technologies that any teacher can use. We have not gone deep into a particular, so the idea is not to focus on a particular technology, rather focus on the pedagogy through which, or the process through which this technology can be utilized effectively in integrating teaching learning process. So if you want people to collaborate, I would recommend Wikispaces, but the same is now possible even in WordPress, but you have to do a local installation. Again, with user permissions and other things, it is really up to you on how you are exploiting the features and affordances of both Wikispaces and WordPress. So there is no right answer for this question, but all I would look at is align the technology's use to the learning purpose. So go and look into the Digital Bloom's taxonomy videos that I have uploaded as learning extension resource this week. You will get a better idea about learning purposes and aligning technologies. Okay, one last question for this particular session. I'll be coming back. So we'll be having the final Q&A session at 4 o'clock. For the time being, this is the last question for this particular session. This is from RC1226, Loyola ICAM College.
Sir, good afternoon, Mr. JK.
Yeah.
Thank you for your elaborating the entire day with MOOC as well as that wiki.
Okay.
I have one doubt. How far this wiki will be useful for active learning strategy?
So, wiki is actually useful, very useful for active learning. So, I told you that we have done peer assessment in wikis. We have done think, pair, share using wikis. We have also done team, pair, solo using wikis. So, it is how you exploit the functionality of wikis to actually integrate a strategy. So, for example, for think, pair, share, what we did was each participant has their own individual page where they will write their views about a particular focus question. In the pair phase, we'll ask participants to go and visit somebody else's page and comment on it. So, this is the pair and there is a discussion that is happening. And in the share phase, both of them, we'll ask each and every participant to come together to a common page where they will finally write down the refined understanding that they have about the focus question and will create a page. So, this is think, pair and share, and this page is actually visible from the home page. So, we have done think, pair, share like that. Now, team, pair, solo, it is the reverse. They will start from a starting template page where they will populate. They will populate it as a team. From there, they will go to their own pair pages where they will populate as a pair. And finally, there will be an individual activity where they will do it, they will create their own individual pages. Then it could be used for jigsaw where you provide multiple pages and multiple questions within the wiki. There is discussion that is happening. So essentially, it all depends on how you are utilizing the affordances provided by this technology for both collaboration, for individual resource creation or curation, and specific permissions that are there available within each page.
Whether we have any feature like MOOC type of features like any the quiz assignment shall we provide to the students, that features available in wiki?
So wiki in its elemental form, it is not a learning management system. It is merely a content management system. But you can integrate external third party applications which runs in HTML, like online quizzes that can be embedded. So, for example, you can embed a Google form inside a wiki page and then still do assessments inside the wiki. That is possible.
Thank you, sir. But, thank you very much.
Yeah. So, I see a lot of hand raises. Please hold on to the hand raises. We'll be coming back at 4 o'clock. We will do a complete elaboration debriefing about OER activities. We'll clarify all your doubts regarding OER, the wiki activities, or in general, the other queries that you have about FDP 201, from 4 o'clock today. So, today 4 to 5:30, we will have an extended Q&A session. People who want to try out Wiki Spaces in lab, they are free to move ahead to the lab and try it out. If you want to participate in the Q&A session, understand with the Q&A session, then please also another option is that you can use the YouTube channel of Studio IIT Bombay, where we'll be streaming this Q&A session. All the hand raises, I'll come to you individually. So people who are having questions. So one important thing to note now is that if one particular question, if your question has been answered, kindly lower the hand. So remove the hand raise so that others will get a chance to ask their question. So we'll be back exactly at 4 o'clock. So now it is a tea break.